Hello, I wonder if you've heard of the Residual Current Device, or RCD. It saved my life in the past. There's a couple of kinds that you can get. You can get these plug-in types, or you get these ones which sit on fuse boards. But I wonder if you know how it works. So here is a simplified diagram of an RCD. There is an iron core, and the electricity that supplies the device, coming via a live and a neutral wire, passes through this switch gear and then through a coil which goes around the iron core. Now, when electricity passes around a coil, it generates a magnetic field. So a magnetic field will be generated inside this core, and that goes out to the device. Now, the device uses the electricity, or uses an energy supplied with electricity, but the current returning through the neutral wire should be the same as the current supplied. But the coil there is wired the other way around, and so this produces a magnetic field that's reversed, the opposite to the input coil. So you get a magnetic field produced by one coil, the live wire, and a magnetic field produced by the neutral wire. And in normal operation, these two currents will be the same, and so these two magnetic fields will be the same, and they cancel each other out. Now you get no magnetic field overall, and so nothing happens to the switch gear. However, if there's a fault in an appliance, sometimes the electricity can leak away to the ground. So instead of going through the appliance and back down the neutral wire, some electricity leaks away to ground. And this can happen if you cut through an electric cable, perhaps with a power tool. In that instance, the current supplying the device would still be the same, and so the magnetic field to that device would be the same as it was before, but less current would return along the neutral wire as some is leaking away to earth. And so the magnetic field through the produced by the coil and the neutral wire will be less than the magnetic field produced by the coil and the live wire. And that leaves a net magnetic field, which will of course attract iron objects. Now the switch gear has a black bit at the bottom which is made of iron. And so that bit would be attracted towards the coil, the iron core, and would break the circuit. So if there's a fault where something leaks, some current leaks away to earth, the magnetic field pulls on the magnetic switch, the iron in the magnetic switch, and breaks the circuit. And then you need to press the reset button to push this back into place. Now that's a simplified version of an RCD. And I want to show you a diagram here of an actual design. I've only drawn a few coils, but the principle is pretty much the same. Electricity is supplied down the live wire, and it goes through some coils and then off to the device. And it returns along the neutral wire through some coils again, wound in the other way this time, and back through here. And here is the switch gear. Now the switch gear is held in place, or it's pulled up by this spring, but it's held in place by this magnetic arrangement here. The permanent magnet produces a magnetic field which flows through the iron part of the switch gear and back down to the north pole of the magnet. And so they're attracting the iron, and it holds it down in place. It has to be a sufficient force to withstand the pulling of this spring. In normal operation, the live current is the same as the neutral current. And so the two magnetic fields which these coils produce are equal and opposite, and they cancel each other out. That means that there is no net magnetic field produced inside the green search coil, and so no current will be induced in it, and so no electricity flows through this coil here. However, if there's something wrong, then the current supplied is greater than the current that returns. And that means that there's a greater magnetic field here than here. And so you end up with a net magnetic field. A net magnetic field will produce a voltage across this coil. And it does so, if you know a little bit more about electromagnetic induction, because these are actually alternating currents. And the changing magnetic field induces a changing alternating current inside this coil. And that current was passed across to this coil, which then produces a magnetic field. So here's the current through that coil. And just as before, you have the magnetic field by the permanent magnet, which attracts the iron core, or the iron bit of the rocker switch. But now you've got an opposing magnetic field caused by this coil. And so these two magnetic fields cancel each other out. It's like putting another magnet upside down, reversed, to cancel this one. And that means that this iron is no longer attracted to this arrangement, and the spring can pull it back up again. And that trips the circuit. And to reset it, you have to manually press down here to push it back into place. So that's one operation of a RCD. They can be extremely useful to protect you if there's any electricity leaking to earth, as would happen if you cut through a cable. And if you haven't got one on your circuit board, get one. It could save your life too.